Hello guys, welcome back. So in this video, I'm going to give you some tips and guide on how to set up your character and also set up your course. Okay, I'm going to explain from the character first. Combat mode activated. Okay, basically, if you check on the guide from this game, you might find several guides which characters that you should use. Okay. So right now, basically, what you should do, or you might want to try, first, you might want to try to have one character of firepower, and then two characters of spec ops type, yeah. Or maybe you want to try again, to have two character of firepower and one character spec ops. And actually, it's a quite good combination if you want, if you maybe you feel quite bored to just using this kind of character, you might want to try to use maybe a combination of Layla and maybe Scarlet. Okay, so you might want to use two firepower character and one spec up. It's okay, you can try it and you can try to do trial and error. Okay, but for me right now, the best is actually using one firepower plus two character spec ops, and actually it really boosts the damage, yeah, of the characters. Okay, now I'm going to explain a little bit from the Travel Spacey. Okay, this is what I have: critical rate 44%, and since he has the recommended attributes to increase, he has close range damage bonus by 25%, and good thing I have critical damage by 80%, yeah guys. Okay, this 80% is the combination from the cores and also the gears and the gems, and also similar to the critical rate, I have a small rate from the critical from the gears and also from the gems. Okay, let me check a little bit. I think I have it from the I think from the gems in that case. Yeah, this one, the gems has the critical rate by 3%, and then also from this one, and also from this one, the boots, see guys. That's why I have more critical rate for travel. Okay, now about the I think I'm going on for the Nadia. I'm going to discuss about why Nadia is important to use. Okay, it's because I'm going to go into the promotion. Okay, you know this is Nadia actually more specialist on the healing, but he has another skill that really help a travel, and then this one. Okay, the second slot skill is actually increase critical rate by 10% for characters with more than 50% HP, which is, this is very good. Okay, I'm going to write this one. Okay, let me check. If I was not wrong, oh, okay, 40, yeah, it's okay lah, yeah, 44.6%, yeah, just little bit. So basically, when I used Nadia, actually, she's able to increase travel critical rate become 10%, yeah. So he has 50% critical rate now, okay, because of this her skill, passive skill. Okay, and then this is the healing. When you have a better weapon, you can unlock healing for bigger HP, I guess. Increase the healing bigger. Okay, that's about Nadia that I can discuss. Okay, and also her ultimate skill is really good to increase the attack by 35% for 13 seconds, yeah, once you already used ultimate, guys. Okay, I guess I'm going to write like this one. Nadia passive, ultimate, ultimate, 35% attack for 13 seconds. Okay, now let's move on to the Haran, yeah? Face the sun and your shadow stay behind. Okay, once he used this skill, he can increase the close range damage bonus, and which is, this is very very good for Trevor. Yeah, okay, I guess I'm going to write it down for Haran, yeah? Okay, and then for the second passive, it will increase the allied character's freeze damage bonus, you guys, by 10%. Okay, and then plus 1% freeze damage bonus. I'm not really understand about this sentence. It will increase 5% critical damage, but just 1% freeze damage here. Okay, so I write this down. 10% damage, 10% freeze damage equal with 50% critical damage. But I'm still not really sure about this one, about this sentence, you guys. So, maybe if you have several, maybe if you understand about this thing, you may try to put in the comment. But my assumption is, I think, for the passive second passive of Haran, his freeze damage actually gives 50% of critical damage, yeah? Which is, if it's true, it's really really going to be super super powerful for Trevor, guys. Okay, now let's... Okay, this ultimate doesn't have any passive. Okay, this is the passive skill of Haran, which is basically I'm going to write on this one. Okay, when Haran inflicts a freeze, the whole team able to gain 10% critical rate, which is very very good. So right now I have 12% critical rate. From the passive here. Freeze enemy. So my Trevor actually has 60% 60%, yeah, 66%, you guys. 66% of critical rate. Okay, and then I support spike, not really much contribute for the critical rate, critical rate, and yeah, for the, it's not really much contribute for the critical rate, but actually it also able to give you the summon to attack the enemy, yeah. Okay, this one is really really good. Allied characters within range of the Hammering Ice Cone and Frost for every 5% of critical Haran's critical damage, increase the entire team's skill damage by 2%. Okay. Another skill for Trevor again, guys. Okay, now I already write down my Haran's critical damage. I have 71% of Haran's critical damage, which is actually equal to 28% of team skill damage. Okay, so the calculation is from 70%, 70 divided by 5 and then multiply by 2, which is it's 28% team skill damage. Okay, so far this is my character setup ya. Yeah. Maybe I can say this is some kind of the breakdown ya yeah, guys. Okay, I might want to give you some a little bit conclusion ya. Yeah. So the best way is actually use one firepower character and then plus two spec ops. If you want to try and do trial and error, you might want to try to have two firepower character and then one spec op character. Okay. And then this is my travel critical rate with Nadia and also Haran. Okay, and the total become 66.5% critical rate, guys. Which he become more powerful. And also Nadia has passive skill, which once she use her ultimate, and it will increase 35% attack power for 13 seconds. Okay, Haran passive actually able to increase the skill by skill ya, 8% close range damage and 10% increase damage equal to 50% critical damage. And then another Haran's passive, 70% Haran's critical damage actually equal to 28% team skill damage. Okay, I guess right now I'm going to discuss about the calls, you guys. Yeah, okay, now about the calls. I already write down the calls building. Okay, so the firepower travel, try to use the firepower character more specialized calls. Okay. Like I have travel, so I'm using Sea Satan calls for calls and also space tank. Or you want to change with the Big Chi, it's great as well because Big Chi is increasing the critical damage, you guys. So since last time I didn't farm the Big Chi, so I only have the space tank. So I'm going to use space tank, yeah. But I recommend you. You can try to use the Big Chi to do, I mean, to have more critical damage, yeah, more bigger. The reason why I'm using a space tank because it gives the close range damage bonus, which actually increasing the attribute for the recommended attribute for travel, yeah, guys. That's why I'm using that one. Okay, I'm going to write down some of this one. Okay, and then this is for travel skill. Okay, for Sea Satan call actually for two piece increase the critical rate by 12%, which is he become very good, and the post the four piece become super powerful because once you use one skill of travel, you can shot the damage like 120% damage. Okay, if it's the critical damage, it's gonna be super bigger than this 120% damage, yeah. So travel become super powerful because of this one, guys. And also the ice tank, which you can try to change with the Big Chi, okay, like this one, guys. Okay, critical damage 24%, but if you use the space tank, it's gonna be close range damage by 12%. Okay. And then last time I was quite lucky to get a really great combination of the passive sub passive skills, something like that. Critical damage, critical rate, close range damage bonus. But I'm still using this 2-star, you know, because it's really rare to get this one. And then this one, critical rate, critical damage, but it's long range, yeah. It's a long range. And then critical damage, critical rate plus range damage bonus, space tank, critical damage and close range, but no critical rate, yeah. Critical rate and the critical damage 20%, super big, guys. Okay, that's about my travel, which is why I was quite lucky, yeah, to get a lot of things. Okay, and then I'm going to discuss about Nadia. Basically, Nadia and Haran is the same way to equip the course, yeah. So far, this is what I used for them. I'm going to write down again. Okay, now as you can see that using this Fall Walker 2 to a piece and a steel worm for piece, you can actually able to get attack by 16%, and this is a passive skill permanently. And if you use both two characters, it's going to be stackable. Okay, so it's going to be stackable, become 32% attack power if you use both two characters here, yeah? Using Fall Walker and Steel Worm. And also the passive skill of Steel Worm, once you switch to the character that has the Steel Worm, it will increase attack by 15%, which is wow, it's really, really powerful, guys. 15% just for 10 seconds, yeah, guys. Okay, just let me show you my Nadia a little bit. Okay, this is Steel Worm. 4 piece of Steel Worm gives you 10% attack, yeah. And then for Fall Walker, 2 piece gives you 6%. 2 piece of Steel Worm gives you increase the attack by 15% for 10 seconds, and it triggers once every 20 seconds. Okay, that's about it. I was really, really lucky as well to get critical rate, critical damage, critical rate and critical damage, critical damage and critical rate again. And that one is really, really big. Critical rate 10% is quite big, and it's very, very rare to get, yeah. And then this one, critical rate, critical damage, critical damage, critical rate. Wow, super, super. And also, okay, right now I'm still building for my Haran. I don't really have much good course, only this one. That's why you see a lot of 2 stars. I'm still collecting this one, critical rate, critical damage. Okay, now how do I know why it's gonna be stackable, the Steel Worm and Fall Walker? Okay, I think let me show you a little bit, yeah, on the gene range. Okay, now you see that I have 2 buffs on this this one. Okay, Fall Walker call, and I have two buffs, yeah, this one, 2, and also 2, Steel Worm, which is, it becomes 32% of attack power, guys. Okay, now you might want to ask about why should we use the assault rifle, the freeze gun. Okay, I'm not really that understand everything, yeah. Just you can check on this one, go to the character weapon, tap on the icon of the type weapon. Okay, you see that there is a weak weapon. Okay, the effect of the weak weapon, once you deal the debuff of weak, it said that use a AoE weapons to hit the weak point more easily, and then it's something like rounded circling, something like that. This is some kind of the looping, maybe from this debuff, go to here, go to here, go to here, go to here, back again, like it's similar to when you play on shootout challenge in the club. Okay, so now when you use the freeze gun to deal extra damage, use a high DPS weapon to trigger greater damage, which is the best is the shotgun. This one, guys. The fire, you can use the fire, but the best is actually shotgun. I already tried, and shotgun is the best way to use the ignite debuff. Okay, that's why I'm using Trevor, and then Nadia, and then Haran. Once I use Haran with the freeze, then I shoot with Trevor. It will deal very very big damage, you guys. And that's why I can deal super big damage on the Jhin range, 25 million damage. Okay. Right now my damage is at the 24 rank. My blood in all from all my friends that I friend with them, I am the number one at the moment. Okay, I guess that's it, guys. Hopefully you can understand everything. And if you have any advice for me, you may put the comment on my video. And thank you very much for watching. You can subscribe this channel to get more interesting videos. And see you next time. Bye bye, guys.